Hey, what's going on, everyone? My name is Craig, and welcome to episode 9 of CraigCraft Season 1. Hopefully, you are having a great day and are excited to be continuing this series. If you guys missed last episode, I'll link down below in the description. Lots of stuff happened, so definitely would go recommend checking that out. But what I did figure out why our brightness was not like... Because I changed the gamma in the Minecraft settings to 100%, so we're able to see in these dark caves so you guys can see properly as well. But it's because I had the other, if I go to it, I had two resource packs on. I had this one on and a different one on, and the other one made it dark. So I sadly won't probably be able to use that other one unless it's like daytime, or maybe like now it'd be fine since we're not going out in the night. But that is kind of annoying. It is what it is, though. We can't really change anything about that. So that's that. But today I've got some pretty big plans. I actually want to start by getting, let's go to sleep real fast, but I want to start by getting some of the materials we will need for, our real house that we're going to make. And I'm going to call it a compound. Obviously it's going to be a house, but it's going to be a compound because we want to have it very, very well lit, very, very well protected. So obviously we won't die. None of our animals will die. Nothing else will be able to get inside of it. So that's kind of what we're going to be going for with this design, but it will obviously take a while to build because it's going to be pretty big. I think it's about like, oh, these dudes are hanging out. Did he drop a carrot? Is that the second carrot drop I've gotten from like zombies in like the first couple episodes? It's kind of crazy. But yeah, so it's going to be a very, very big design. Like each side of it, like it's going to be basically a square to start off, and then we'll expand it from there, but it's going to be huge. It's like 60 by 60 almost. It's not exactly that. I have the coordinate or the calculations on a separate text document that I have, but it's like 60 by 60. Our house right now is 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 by 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 by 7. Imagine 60 by 60. It's ridiculous, but hopefully you guys will like it. I didn't find a cool design that I'm going to go for. I'm going to change it up a good amount, but it's at least what I think I'm gonna base off a certain design I found just by browsing some on the Minecraft forums. I actually found it, so it's pretty cool. But we do need some materials for that we sadly don't have, and they're sadly kind of hard to get just because of the resources are so rare in this series. We need to have a shear, so we are gonna be getting loads and loads of leaves because that's kind of gonna be on the outside of our house or our new compound that we're gonna make. Now, shears, you do need, I think, 2 pieces of iron to make a shear. Well, let's just check it out just to confirm that if you guys want to check it out as well. Shears, where are they? Right there. So 2 pieces of iron are super expensive for a shear, especially because we don't have much iron. And also, we'll have to get a lot of these leaves. So we're going to go through a lot of shears, which is really not too good. But what we could do is if I go... onto my second text document for just a quick sec right here. If I look up the price of shears, so let's just check this out. I can't even find shear, so they might not even be. I don't even think you can get a shear on here. I'll quickly go through them real fast. I don't think. Oh wait, there it's SH. Wait, where is it? I just saw it. I spelled it wrong, but I mean, I said S-H-E-E-R, it's S-H-E-A-R. There's 604, so yeah, we'll definitely want to get shears. We'll want to buy them. We won't want to use our iron, because our iron's 2,000 a piece, so we'll definitely want to buy them if there's only 604. So I'm glad I looked that up real fast here. All right, cool. So 604 coins, we have 20,000, almost 21,000, so we'll definitely be fine for that. We're going to want to get a good amount of them as well. So what I'm going to have to do here real fast, hold up, let me close this. Oh, someone's opening up on my computer. There we go. All right. So I go to cheats just for a second because I have to do this to go into game mode 1. I'm going to buy myself a shear. I just have to buy one, so I'll have it. All right, so we do that, buy, and then we take both of those. It did reduce our coins. Then we'll put this in the deleting section, go back. That's the only way to do it, which kind of sucks, but it is what it is. So we have our lovely, lovely shear here. And if we put that back in, we can buy it. So we'll have to actually buy another one because I need one to keep just as reference. So I can just quickly buy it. I don't have to go into game mode again, essentially. So that's cool. We have two of those now. Still have a load of coins, but we're going to go through these quickly. You'll see what I mean just when we go use up like the first one. But I think of the leaves I'm trying to go for are, I was thinking about using like spruce or birch, but I think at least for now I'm going to use oak. I think oak will look the best with the design that I'm going for. So that is what we're going to be trying to get a lot of. And the easy way to get to that is just in spawn. I don't really feel like destroying all these trees over here just yet. So we're going to go probably to spawn to get most of the leaves. Could even put our own trees up if we really wanted to. But another thing is, I know I'm trying to talk about a lot of things here, are enchants. Now, I think the only enchant you can get, and I'm going to look this up real fast just so I'm sure on this. So enchants on shears Minecraft. So I'm just going to Google search that real fast because I'm really not entirely too sure what you can get on shears. So I just want to look it up for you. Really quickly here, because shears, like I said, since they're still pretty expensive. 604 is not cheap at all, so we may want to make sure we can get the maximum ability out of them. So you can get efficiency on breaking, and I guess it's just efficiency on breaking. It says you can put silk touch on it, but not after 1.8.8. I don't know why you'd want silk touch. I don't know. Okay, so efficiency and unbreaking are the main two we can get. So obviously we're going to want to get unbreaking. I don't really care about efficiency at this point. So if we can get a lot of unbreaking books, that would be useful. And then just attach them all to the shears. So let us, or we could even try to enchant the shear itself. I don't know. We need some lapis actually first. So let's do that. Go to the shears. All right. Put it down. I don't even know if you can enchant it directly. No, you can't. So is the only way to do it, like, actually just getting a lot of protection on books? Or maybe it's just because we don't have any bookshelves around. I'm not too sure. Where's our books? Okay, so I want to just try to get, not protection one, I want to try to get unbreaking on this, if all possible. Protection. Okay. Protection is not bad. I'm just going to get that so we'll kind of reset the enchants. Efficiency. Not really what I want. But I don't think there's any way to really reset them. If you put something else in, does that reset them for the previous thing? I don't know. I don't think it does. I don't know. I think you actually have to enchant something to reset them. Or if you go out of it. So if I put this in and then go out of it, will that reset them for the books? I have no idea. There is a way to do it, I'm pretty sure. Oh, no, it didn't reset. Okay, so we're just going to get an efficiency one there. And let's see what we can get on this final book. Sharpness. Oh, we could get unbreaking. It's 8 levels, though. Is that worth it? Should we do it? That's the I don't know if it's worth it. It might be dumb to do this, but I might just go for it right away. Let's do it. I know it's like that's a lot of levels for such a low enchant, but I think it will... It will pay off. It'll save us a little bit of iron, but we can't even combine those. So, we will have to get an anvil. That's 10,000, but it is what we have to do. Alright. Let's go into game mode 1. Get out anvil. I think it's about 10,000, so we want a new anvil right there. Put that in here. Subtract all of that. So, we want to buy an anvil. So, there we go. 10,407 coins left. Then we have to get rid of one of ours. Didn't deserve to, at least yet. Would be nice if we could find just an extra anvil in one of these dungeons. That would be pretty sweet, because these will eventually crack and break, but it is what it is. Alright, feel bad using a shear up on this, but we have to. Alright, unbreaking one right there. We could just put efficiency on it if we want to. Might as well, like, it's 2 levels. We have really nothing else to spend our levels on. We'll throw the protection one book to the side for it right now. Okay, cool. So we do have now a shear that is enchanted. I'm not going to enchant all of them, because we'll have to definitely get more, but at least we have one for now that will work with what we need. Okay, so now we got to get to spawn. Oh, that's not what I wanted. Spawn, there we go. Because there's so many leaves around here that we can easily get. And you can see the... What? Does not... Oh, I didn't use up any yet. I was going to say, I thought I might be in game mode 1 still, but no, I'm not. Okay, there we go. Now I finally used it up. So... We only get like 236 usages out of this. So it's like, we'll only get like around 230. I don't know how many we'll need. We'll definitely need a lot. I don't want to take too many from this tree because it's kind of our spawn tree. I'll go out a little bit further. But I don't want to like, I don't know. I have to go through a lot of these because like I said, we just need that many for this compound based design. But it does kind of suck that these things don't have as good of durability and usage with the iron, because it does cost 600. It's like a lot. I mean, it's not cheap at all. It's almost like half of what a normal iron ingot would be, because iron is 2,000, so it's like almost 1,600. So You know what I'm saying? It's about half, so it is still an expensive item. But, like I said, it is necessary for this design. I think it'll look cool. But it will take a while to build this as well. It's not going to be like a one-episode thing. It'll be probably many episodes until we get it perfectly how we want this base. And that's kind of cool. I don't want to, like... Obviously, I don't want to, like, rush it. Kind of talked about this a little bit on last, but I don't want to rush it. Rush this series at all, because I'm having a load of fun with it already. And, yeah, so that's why I'm going to take our time, get all the stuff we need, and make it look nice. I don't want to make it look very bad, because I feel like I didn't spend enough time in my house in my Xbox One Adventure world. That was our last kind of survival Minecraft world we did. Had a load of fun on that one as well, but I didn't spend enough time in the house on that one. So I really want to make sure we can make it a little bit nicer in this one, and have it looking very, very good. I think you guys will like it as well once I finish it. All right, what are we at now? So we're at another 94. All right, that's cool. It's cool. I don't want to miss out on any of these, though, because did take a usage up of this thing. So I want to make sure I collect all these. All right, let's keep on going, though. Let's get as many as we can. Good stuff, good stuff. What happened to me today? Just trying to talk to you guys about random stuff while we get all these things collected. Today, I actually watched a movie with my parents. I watched Mad Max, the new one that came out, not like the original ones. I know it's been out for like a while now, but I don't know how too long. Not too long, but a good amount of time. We just watched it, though, finally, and it was okay. Like, I never saw the original one, so I really didn't know what the story was about. So I kind of Googled it just to find out, but I didn't want to spoil anything. So I still watched the remake of this new one, but it was okay. It wasn't like, I don't know, it seemed... Like, and I don't want to spoil it for you guys, so I'm sorry if you guys haven't seen it yet or want to see it, don't, like, listen to this, just skip this part of the video or whatever, but, I thought it was, like, pretty boring, honestly, I don't know. It was very action-y, and I liked that, but I wish they would have done more, like, character development and build-up for that movie, because it just seemed like the entire movie was, they're trying to escape this area, and then they go back to it. But during that entire time, they're just, like, fighting on trucks. I really thought that was cool. Like, don't get me wrong. That was awesome. But it just, like, I wish they would have done a little bit more character build-up. Because I was kind of confused on really what some of the characters' kind of morals and goals were. But maybe that's just me. I just thought it was kind of repetitive. I wish there would have been a little bit, some different stuff that could have gone on. Like, I think a cool fight with the main boss guy for, like, the big compound area that they have. With all the resources. I think the main boss guy, like, a battle with him and Max would have been cool. But, like, a fighting scene, I think that would have been added to the story. But, sadly, it did not. What happened there? Why did our thing just get reset? That's weird. Did you guys see that? The enchants fell off of it, on it, but the thing got reset. Or, no. Oh, no, shoot. That's not true. This is our other one. Oh man, that could have been bad. This is our other shear. The one because we bought two of them, remember? So that they didn't get reset or anything. That's our other shear. Okay, good. I'm glad I caught that. I'm just going to use it up a little bit, but I will have to kind of not deplete it all the way because then I won't have any reference to buy my next one on. We need our next one. So I'll use it up a little bit, but I got to watch out. It's going to go down a lot faster than the other one because the other one had efficiency and on breaking. I don't even know if you really need efficiency on shears. I decided to put it on because they already mined through the leaves pretty quickly, but I just wanted to use up that efficiency book to get it out of the way. I will eventually want to get like a bunch of protection one books, a bunch of efficiency books and power books so I can get all those enchants onto my weapons and gear. So I don't have to be like guessing and playing around as much with the enchants and kind of just pick and choose more. I know with the 1.8 enchanting, it basically is that. You can kind of pick what enchants you get and what ones you want compared to the previous enchanting in Minecraft. But I don't know. I feel like getting those level ones are better because I don't want to spend 30 or not 30. You only lose a few of your levels when you do a level 30 enchant. But I don't want to spend all those levels, hard-earned levels, on like a level 30 enchant right away if I don't need it. So we'll play around with that. Because we do need to get some good stuff. How much is this? 25 left. Alright. I don't want to use all of it. So it says 12. Alright, 7. I'm not gonna risk any more of it right now. We'll just go get another one. I don't want to accidentally use it. Let's get all these that we dropped, though. Alright, and we'll see how many of these stacks we got, of these leaves. I'm telling you guys, we will need a lot. We really will. Alright, there we go. Somebody we got. Oh, I didn't want birch. It's okay, though. All right, we got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. That's pretty good. That's actually a lot. I'm gonna come back and do this maybe one more time, really fast here. So let us teleport back home. First, go to sleep real fast. We'll have to buy one more, and then well, I think we might need more after that, but for now, that's a good start on the leaves that we will need. All right, we're just gonna throw all of these in here. I don't have any. Like, I'm running out of chest room. I don't have many spots in those other chests, so we're gonna store all that crap in here for now. Let's buy another one of these. I love that you can buy items, but obviously it does get pricey, especially for valuable items like this, because iron's so expensive. But I'm glad, like I said, that I looked at the shears to make sure they were less expensive than buying just two iron ingots itself, and then using those up. So kind of saved us, what, 1,400 coins? So that's pretty good. More than that. Saved us, because if you do 2,000 times 2, it's 4,000 minus 600. So it saved us a lot, to be honest with you. What am I trying to do? I'm trying to eat up. I don't know why I was trying to type stuff. I'm trying to eat up. Alright. Let's keep on getting some more of this stuff here. So yeah, enchants, like, obviously we can start messing around with them. We kind of did today already on this episode. Since we do have the enchant table. And all, I did not think we'd get it this early, so that's kind of why I'm still thinking about what I'm gonna exactly enchant. If I like, what do you guys think? Should I go for a pickaxe and try to get like a good fortune pickaxe right away? So if we find any diamonds or anything like that, we can get like double, triple, quad drops from those. Do you guys think I should go for that strategy, or do you think I should go for the looting side of it and get a really good looting sword with sharpness 4 so I can be able to battle things easier and not be kind of scared about that or anything. Like, yeah, I should go for armor. I really want to know what you guys think because I'm not too sure. Obviously, we don't have much iron, so I can't, like, just throw away the iron. I want to make sure it gets to good use, whatever that might be. But I'm really thinking a pickaxe at first because we still want to make sure. What is down here? I check that out in a second. I think I'm gonna go for a pickaxe, but I want to know what you guys think because a pickaxe, if we get that right away, we will be able to. Like I said, if we get like a Fortune 3 pickaxe, and we do need a lot of books still for that, but a lot of bookshelves because we can't even do a level 30 enchant. But if we can get that soon, then we'll be able to maybe get double diamond drops and stuff like that. That'll speed us up so we can make a diamond pickaxe to go to the Nether. So I don't know. I'm thinking about that. Maybe we should not even worry about a pickaxe yet until we get just another diamond. So we can have enough diamonds to make a diamond pickaxe and then enchant that. So we don't really waste our enchants on an iron one. Because diamond pickaxes have so much more durability than iron. But I don't know. We'll figure it out. All right. We used that one up. Oh, shoot. I used up both of them. I accidentally used up both of them. Because the other one only had 12, because it automatically switches to it since I have the PvP thing on. Alright, that's fine. I kind of forgot about that. That's okay, though. Didn't get as nearly as much from the other ones, though. Because the other one had efficiency and what was the other thing? Efficiency and, I can't think of, unbreaking. So it got us more with that one. We didn't get nearly enough at all there. That's okay, though. Alright, I want to check out that cave real fast before we go back home. It might not even be a cave. It might just be a big hole, but we'll see. Alright, what is this? Is this really a cave system? Wow. Okay. I guess this is a small cave system. I'm not... Like, you can see on the mini map, I was surprised. This is all right under here. It'd been nice to find this on the first episode. We'll see if there's anything down here. I don't want to spend a terrible amount of time down here, but I always say that, and then get kind of sucked down here, because I love mining. It's probably... I don't know. It might be my favorite thing in Minecraft. I do love building, though, too. I never spend enough time on my builds, and that's something I really wanted to do on this series, is to spend a lot more time on builds, be more proud of them than what I've used to just kind of by rushing them and stuff. But yes, we got already a piece of iron here. So yeah, that's, I'm really going to try to do that, and I do apologize, I haven't really done that in my other series enough, I'd say. But, wow, this is a big find. So we already got another piece of iron. That's cool. So we already kind of made our money back, if you want to think about it like that, from the, from all of the, what are they called, shears. So that's actually really awesome. It'd be really nice to find a diamond, because then we could get a diamond pickaxe made, be able to go to the Nether, and enchant that and stuff, so we can maybe get fortune on that. It would be nice. I want to see how much fall damage I'll take from this. So only one heart. I feel like you get more than that. Obviously, we had some armor on stuff, but I feel like you get more hearts from that if I didn't have the athletics thing up a lot, that ability, because that ability, like I said, makes it so I don't have as much fall damage, which is very, very useful, especially just like evading things and stuff like that. All right, glowstone. Nope. Sometimes those things drop glowstone, which is kind of useful. All right, I feel like I'm going in circles now. Is there anything over here? Some lava. I really want to try to find like one diamond. That would be amazing if we could do that. Or iron. Like even just more iron is always useful. But one diamond would be freaking awesome. It's not going to be this high. I know that. I just want to see if this connects to anything else. Nope. It kind of does on the mini map. You can see there. But for now, I'm not going to worry about that. All right. Let's go back this way. Anything? Nope. Nothing at all. There's more lava down there, but I don't really feel like mining through that. If I had a water bucket, I'd be more up for it. Maybe I should make a water bucket. Like, I've still been pushing that back, and I know some of you guys have probably wanted me to make one now for a while, but I have been pushing it back just because I've still been hoping to find one, but maybe we'll just make that right when we get home, so we'll have that kind of made and done with for now. All right, lava, you scare me. Please leave. Please leave me alone. More lava. Look at this. Ridiculous with the amount of lava finds we're encountering here. All right, nothing from that. Okay. This goes up a little bit. That looks cool. That down there looks... Oh, whoa. Okay, if you look on the mini-map there, you can see there's a little bit of... Right on the top of it, right on the top, there's a little bit of brown. That could be there's a mine shaft down there. That's what that could mean. So... we might want to go check that out. Let's see. See if there's anything else up here first, and then we will maybe go hit that up, because that would be awesome. Found another. That'd be the second mine shaft. I think I marked the first one as a teleporting waypoint if you ever want to go check it out again. I'm sure there's more resource and stuff down there that we could get. That'd be valuable. Yes, I think that is a mine shaft. It looks like a small one, though. Maybe not, actually. Not too sure, because it also looks like there might be a dungeon there, so... We'll check this out. I don't really feel like falling in the lava. All right, let's go this way. Almost fell in the lava there. That could have been the end of me. Oh, yes, it is a mine shaft. Sweet. First, though, I'm going to go down here for a second. Nothing. All right, let's get back up. Cool. So mine shaft is nice. It does have a higher chance of probably finding diamonds than just going through a random cave and hoping to find diamonds just because... You can get them in chests and stuff like that. Oh, whoa! Dude! Who are you? Who do you think you are? Alright, let's get back up here. If we can. And, wow, okay. Oh, there's a chest already. Just caught it at the corner of my eye there. Ooh, is that a... This might be a... Yeah, it's a ravine, I think, as well. Please, diamonds! Please! Oh, no diamonds. Alright, melon seeds. The heads just aren't useful. Ooh, we got gold there. Take that. The heads just aren't that useful, guys. Is this all the mineshaft? This might be it. No, it looks like it connects through this way, too. Okay, let's go. I don't know. Should I hit the ravine up first? Because I don't want to miss the ravine. I could even collect some of these up and just sell them right away. Because you do make a lot of money off of these carts and stuff. Or off of the tracks. I'm sure you make some off the carts. But I want to collect them anyway. I should have been collecting them before. Because it costs, what, like... 6 iron to make one of those mine carts, so they are pretty expensive. Obviously, I probably won't ever make them. I'll just go back to a mine shaft and look around for them. All right, I'm gonna mark this as the. I think this is mine shaft 2. Let's just check out. Yeah, so that's mine shaft number 1. So let's do a mine shaft number 2, second mine shaft of the series. Let's have the waypoint right here, so it kind of splits it from there and the ravine. Ooh, is it? Oh, whoa. There's loads of stuff. Does a mine shaft go there? Yeah, there's wood there. So, yeah. Cool. Okay. More bones. Not really what we're after. There's a big lava pool there, but I think it might just be below. I don't know. Kind of just running around at this point. I can always just teleport back to that same mine shaft point if I have to, if I kind of get lost. But I can also just use the mini map. I mean, the mini map is so useful. If you guys ever want me to like take it off, if you don't want to see like the whole screen, let me know. That could have been bad. There could have been a freaking... Oh, whoa. Hey, dude. Whoa, you got some armor on, my friend. And you got a freaking enchanted bow. Oh, iron right there. Let's go. Thanks for leading me to the iron, though. I appreciate that. Whoa. Boys, that could have killed me. That actually, I did not hear that until it just came right on me. That could have easily killed me. Oh, my gosh. Wow. Loads of lapis. I'll take it. I need to open up. Do I have my backpack? No, I don't, sadly. Oh, what do I not need? I should have gone home first before doing this, but it's okay. Alright, more iron here. Good stuff. Let's see if there's anything just in this other direction. More mineshaft area. This mineshaft kind of goes all the way along here. It's pretty big. But that's good. That's what you want, because then you'll have a chance of finding more minecarts. That could have diamonds in them. Look how big it is. You can see on the mini-map. Like, it's cool to see how a mineshaft actually is formed on here. Because usually you don't see that, what you're seeing on the mini-map. Right now, there's more iron. Let's go. Found a lot of iron. Like, it's still very, very rare, but at least we're finding it more than we did on the first couple times we went mining. Alright, ooh, this cave spider spawner's down there. Really don't feel like being poisoned, though. That does not make me very, decided to be poisoned. So, ooh, we got gold. Nice. Let's block that up for a second. Want to go get this gold. Double gold drop. There we go. That's huge. It's a big find right there. Alright. Just so many different ways to go here. Oh, more iron. Nice. That's what I'm talking about. Ooh, that stalactite does hurt, though. Get rid of that. The water's so annoying to run through down here. That's the one problem. Like, if you get water down here, it's nice to get, like, if you're on fire or anything, but it's annoying to run through. Wow, this is huge, man. This is absolutely huge. You got more iron. Sweet. Finding a good amount of iron, it's still very, very rare from what it normally is in any Minecraft series, but finding a lot of it right now, which is awesome. Did we get all that? Yes, we did. Any more of it down here in this last little section? Nope. I want to make sure I keep looking up just to see if there's any up top that I'm missing. The bones sometimes actually look like gold to me. So I keep running into them or looking at them, and I always think they're like gold. All right, let's go this way a bit more. It's a very, very cool designed mine shaft. Not gonna lie, it looks really, really nice. I gotta eat up and get up here. Alright, we've explored a good amount, though. Bones. Lots of bones. I don't want to miss, like, a chest down there, either. Oh, shoot, that was bad. Oh, that was really bad. Hey, dude. Hey, dude. Let's get rid of these guys. Because if there's a cart or a chest or anything down here, it'd be nice to just swipe that right away. Don't see any, though. Alright, let's go this way. We might go back down that area there, but I want to go this way a bit just to see if there's any other iron or ore over here that could be useful to us. Doesn't look like it. Okay. It would be annoying if it was up there, because then we'd have to, like, kind of build ourselves up to it, but obviously it's very, very nice if you can get some. It's a big lava pool there. Got a torch. That's actually nice. Glad we got that. Did we pick it up? No, we did not. Like I said, just because torches are so rare. So that's useful. Should we just throw out the coins? I don't want to throw out coins, though. I'm going to throw out my Steve heads. I really wish, like I said, I mentioned this before, I wish that the heads were, like, my own head. It'd be cool, I think. But sadly, it's not how the mod does it. I don't even know what mod that is. It might be the PvP mod that does that, to be honest with you. Like, because maybe when you die, you lose a head. I'm sure, like, I think that would be what the PvP mod would do. Not too sure, though. I don't know. Alright, any other ways to really go? Not this way. Oh my gosh, this is actually a really bad way. Creepers everywhere there. I don't feel like going up, like, upwards, but might be the best way to go right now. Mineshaft keeps like goes far though. It's really, really goes deep. Right, hey, dude. Let's get rid of him. Doing some mad damage to me. Let's go this way. Check out the bones. See if we can get anything from the good old bones. Nothing too much. Is there anything down there? Have we already been down there? Probably have. I don't know. Maybe not, actually. Hold up. This could be new. Got another torch there. This could be new. Ooh, there's iron there. I was not going to go this way, but luckily we found a piece of iron. Good stuff. And you can kind of mine your way through the walls even, since, well, obviously you always could, but you'd want to more now because you can see where, if there's another part of the mine shaft that you haven't explored yet because of the mini-map. So, it's just useful. It really is. There's not many chests on here. You've only found one chest. I'm surprised. There's more of a, if we mine this way a bit, there you can go in another pathway. We'll go this way a small amount. But I'm surprised we've really just not hit any good chests in mine shafts yet. Like, in my Xbox One Adventure, we hit so many good chests in mine shafts. Like, that's how we got so much of our loot. But sadly, in this series, we've not found many mine shafts. Obviously, this is only our second one, but we just haven't had any good loot from them. Any iron. We haven't really gotten any iron from them, which is kind of upsetting. What is this? Just bones here? I want to go back up that other way. It looks like that could be a good way to go. Ooh, we got gold down there. You can kind of see it. All right, let's get these bones first. I don't know. The bones, like, I mean, they're not super useful. The bone, like, the bone ore, whatever you call it. Because they can only drop you, like I said, arrows and stuff. Maybe it has a small chance of dropping diamonds, though, that I just don't know. So, ooh, we got more iron. Nice. How many do we have now? We've found, like, 6 pieces on this one episode, 7 now, alone. Just in this one episode. That's ridiculous, man. That's actually kind of crazy. Like, we've gotten lucky with the iron finds today. Alright, more gold. Nice. I still just don't... Oh, wait. Do we not pick that up? Can we not... Alright, I'm going to log out for a second. Not log out, but just go out of the world for a second because the gold is not going into our inventory for some reason. Alright, gold. Guys, why are we not getting our gold? I don't know why it's doing that. Let me try that one more time. If it's not going to let us have the gold, we're just going to have to go into game mode. Because there's 2 gold. You can see it right there. Alright, it's apparently not giving us the gold. Wow. Okay, we are going to have to go into game mode to give us 2 gold ore. That sucks. I wish it would have just worked, but sadly it did not. Gold. Wait, that's not how you do it. I have to go into this. I was going into the not enough items thing. It's actually this one. Alright, put the gold there. So yeah, we're supposed to have 6. I don't know why I was doing that. It's not working. Alright, it's fine though. We figured it out because it's not letting us pick it up for whatever reason. Just glitched, I guess. Alright, let's keep on going. This way, anything? Really just looking for a chest at this point. It'd be nice. There's bones there, but I don't really want any. Really just want a chest. You know what? Let's go back a little bit, because there was one more area to go. If you guys do remember that. I think it was... Which way was it? I don't think it was this way, but was there anything down here? It's just leading to another cave. Okay, I don't know. I guess we'll skip that last way. Could have been good, but... Or just lead back here? I'm kind of getting confused now. Is this another ravine, or is this the same ravine we've just been in? I think it's the same one. Maybe not. Let's go down here. Oh, hello, dude. See you later. Oh, geez. Do not push me into lava. Okay, no. We've not been down here, because there's redstone right there. More bones. Alright, so this is not new, or we just kind of forgot about it. I have no idea. But we do want to get home soon, so we probably should start wrapping up this mining down here. We mined a good amount. Like, it really wasn't even supposed to be a mining episode. I always say that. I don't know. Okay, I'm sure we just don't have redstone room here. I was going to say, why is it not giving us these items? But we'll figure it out. We don't really need that. Paul. More iron right there. Holy cow. Another iron jaw. I really don't want to lose it, though, so I need to make sure I block this up. I don't want it to just fall down the water and then I just lose it all. Alright. Let's get this single piece of iron right here. Is there anything over here? Doesn't look like it. Don't really feel like jumping over there to explore. Alright, let's go back this way. Because there wasn't there a redstone over here? Yeah, here it is. Alright, hello, skeleton. Hello, Monsieur Skeleton. How are you doing, sir? Don't shoot me, please. He's trying to, guys. Alright, get out of here. There we go. Let's get some of this redstone here. Nice. Alright, yeah, there was nothing around here. Wait. There is a little bit of a area to go up there, though. I don't know. I don't know if it's even worth it. Really, I'm just looking for diamonds, if we could find any. Like, just one diamond. That's all I need. Then I can make a pickaxe. We can do so much more stuff. We can go to the Nether. Like, we can make a lot of new items and do all that good stuff if we can just find one single diamond. But I don't know if we'll be that lucky. Especially in this series. It's even harder than normal. So, I don't know. We'll go this way a bit. No, this is back where we started. This is back where we first found the mineshaft. Okay. So, we should probably just get out of here. We kind of made a big circle here, but it's fine. It kind of wraps it up nicely because we do need to get back home. I don't want to make this episode too long. All right. So, home right there. Teleport away. We got loads of stuff today on this episode. We obviously got a lot of our stuff that I told you guys that we were going to start our new house with. So, we do need a lot of this oak leaves. If you guys are like, why do you want that many? It won't look good. Trust me, it will look good. I know, like, I generally don't use a lot of leaves in my houses, but this one I think is going to look really, really nice. We're going to smelt this stuff up here so it does have that double chance of dropping ores, potentially. We'll see if it gives us any. But yeah, it was very, very productive today. I'm happy about the stuff we got done. And obviously, there's always more to get done. But it's fine. Got some coins. Did have to use some coins up. We got an anvil. We got all that other stuff. We got loads of iron. What did we get? 8 pieces of iron or whatever? It's awesome. So loads of iron and other good stuff as well. Got some small redstone right there. Some more lapis. How much does it cost to sell lapis? And redstone. Because we have so much of it. Like really how valuable is it? 60 and sell is 48. So I don't know. Not too sure. Sell. Wow, redstone's much more valuable than lapis. That's interesting. We have about the same amount of both, but redstone's a lot more valuable than lapis, like a ton. I don't know why. I feel like lapis would be more valuable because lapis you have to use to enchant stuff, so I feel like you just need that, but I guess not. All right, any double drops? Before, got to put some more fuel into that. Wow, did not go in. All right, there we go. Let's have this. Just put a bunch in there. And then we'll see if we can get, I think we had 6. So yeah, we haven't gotten any double drops yet. But we're really looking good on our iron and gold count. I think gold, I don't know, like I was looking at the cost of gold the other day. And gold prices are, obviously gold is hard to find. But the price here for gold, for one piece of gold to sell is about 2,000. So gold really equals an iron almost. So one piece of gold, we can get that many iron. We could get technically another like 33 iron from all this gold if we really wanted to. Or to buy it is 2,400. So it is more expensive than iron as well. So I'm not too sure what to do with that because I obviously want to save that mainly for golden apples. That's like the main thing you do with gold typically. But like, if I go to it, I could actually just search it up. If you guys, I think this will work. If you guys want to see. I don't know if this is exactly... Alright, so yeah, you could see all the stuff you can craft out of gold. Not really too much. Really, like, that's... Is that really it? If I go back into gold... No, it's... I feel like it should tell us... I feel like it'd tell you what you can get with it, but I guess not. That's really like the main stuff you can do with it. All this other gold stuff as well, obviously. So, not too much. Like, golden apples is really about it. You won't want to make any gold tools or armor. golden carrots can be good, I guess. Nuggets are okay. You have to have those for golden apples. So that's about it. And powered rails. But I don't know how much powered rails are. They might be less expensive than doing all that. So another 4 iron and another 3 gold. So is that how many we had? I think so. So we didn't have, still haven't gotten any double drops from that. It kind of does. Kind of is a bummer. I feel like we should. 2x smelt yield. So I don't know. I don't know why we haven't gotten any of that yet. But it's all right. Hope you guys have enjoyed. It's another long episode that we've done today. But loads of progress as always. I think next episode we might keep working on the house, getting more materials and stuff like that. But let me know what you guys want to see down below with a comment in the description, or not in the description, a comment down below in the comment section, because like I said, I want this series to be as much my series as it is yours. Hope you guys enjoyed. If you're new to the channel, please subscribe. Thanks for watching. Have a great day, and I'll see you on our next episode.